Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone, this is Ashima, and in this video we'll be talking about daily current affairs or daily news events. Now this video comprises of detailed discussion, and therefore this video is going to be helpful for all the examination aspirants, be it for banking or for SSC or for UPSC, whichever examination you're preparing for, this is going to be helpful. Apart from that, this video is also going to be helpful for those who are either preparing for interviews or for descriptive examinations, so that wherever you need to gain that information of a certain subject, this video is going to be helpful for you. Right, so don't forget to like the video and share the video. For those who want to practice question sets alongside, that is, want to practice the questions, for them we have everyday free live quiz that happens on Entry app. So you can download Entry app from Google Play Store, and once you do that and complete the initial registration process, you get access to the free live quiz, which is about 15 questions, 15 minutes, and also has a marking set so that you can rank yourself on the amount of knowledge you have gained in a day. So don't forget to download the app, and don't forget to like the video and share the video. Now, moving ahead with the discussion, the first news event we are going to talk about is Mobile Component Unit, which is being set up in Tamil Nadu by Tata. So let's have a look at what exactly is happening. So Tata Electronics has signed an MOU. The MOU is signed with Tamil Nadu government, and under this manufacturing unit is going to be set up. So now the question comes is, what is going to be the outlay of this and what is the purpose of this? First of all, what is the outlay? So 4,684 crores is the cost of the project that has been announced to be set up. Second question, where is it going to be set up? So in Tamil Nadu, in Krishnagiri, it is going to be set up, right? Third thing, how is it going to be beneficial? First of all, it is going to help create jobs. That is, it is going to create employment, and the expectation is about 18,000 plus jobs are going to be created via this setup that has been announced. Apart from that, Tamil Nadu government has signed an MOU with Gersem Industries also for paint manufacturing unit at Cheyyar. So in Cheyyar paint manufacturing unit, with an outlay of about or expenditure of 750 crores, and a mobile manufacturing unit with an expenditure of 4,600 crores approximately. Right? Now, if we talk about both these groups, that is first Tata Group, and then we'll be talking about Gersem Industries. So Tata Group is an Indian conglomerate. First of all, conglomerate being a company which has multiple branches and multiple business. Like we have Tata Communication also, we have Tata Tea also, we have Tata Chemicals also, Tata Consultancy Services also, Power also, Tanishq also. So there are various sectors in which a company has invested, and such a company is known as a conglomerate, and Tata is a conglomerate. Gersem Industries, again, same headquartered in Mumbai, and this is one of the, it is considered as world's best firm compiled by Forbes. So world's best regards firm list was created by Forbes recently, and according to that, Gersem Industries comes in 154th listing. So that means it is again a very diversified group with a quality rank, right? Now, it is also the world's largest producer of viscose rayon fiber. Then going ahead, eChhavni portal that has recently been inaugurated by the Defense Minister of India. So, why has this portal been created? What is the purpose of this? So, let's have a look at that. First of all, who launched it? Defense Minister of India, Rajnath Singh, launched it. Then, what is the purpose? Online municipal services for more than 20 lakh citizens, especially those which are living in cantonment areas. So they can register their civic complaints with civic issues from home, and they can register their complaints and get that solved, which is also going to enhance the ease of living. Then, there are various problems of water and sewage that might be occurring. So those can also be handed over or handled via this portal. Then this there's going to be 762 cantonment boards where this service is going to be provided using this particular portal. Right now, civic cantonment boards are basically civic administration bodies which function under the Ministry of Defense. Why under Ministry of Defense? Because the body that they worked for is Defense Ministry, right? Now, if we talk about a board, a brief idea, first of all, board members are nominated for or elected for a term period of 5 years. Second of all, there can be elected members, ex officio members, and nominated members. Third of all, the act which is there, so Cantonments Act 2006 is the act under which this board has been created, right? All right. Then the next one is Rajasthan Prison Rules 1951, which have been amended. A total of 3 rules which have been amended recently. So what are the 3 rules? So although the rules are stated, but we'll be talking about the rules as well. So first rule is from section 67. Sorry, rule 67, section 2. So what was the rule earlier? It was related to cooking of food. That was that any Brahmin or someone of a higher caste in prison, only they could be appointed for cooking. Now that has been amended. So earlier this rule stated that only Brahmins could cook or someone from a upper caste. Now that has been amended that no inmate will be selected on the basis of caste or religion. Someone who wants to cook can cook, who does not want to or does not know how to cook won't cook. So this caste system is the purpose why this amendment has been brought in by Rajasthan government, and all the 3 amendments are ones which are abolishing caste and religion involvement. Second is a section 1 rule 13 part 10, and in this it was more about tradesmen, that is the barbers, the sweepers. So it was that only non-habitual prisoners can be barbers, or sweepers can be among those who perform sweeping work outside the prison as well, and someone who is not a professional sweeper may or may not do that. So now this has been amended, that is not on basis of on caste or religion can a tradesman be chosen, tradesman being anyone from a barber to a sweeper. Then the third one was rule 17 clause D section 1. Now this was defining the habitual offender as any member of criminal tribe. But this section has been removed now, that is, this is no longer into the picture, right? These are the amendments that have taken place, and these amendments are the ones which abolish, the religious involvement or caste involvement among the prisoners. Then the next one which we have is RBI data on bank credit and deposits. So what is the data of RBI? First of all, bank credit has grown by 5.93%. That means a 5 lakh crore increase has been seen by RBI in terms of bank credit. Then, if we talk about the deposits of bank, they have risen by 11.6%. Now, 11.6% is 98 lakh crore. So, we can say that about 133.24 lakh crore increment has been seen in the this much deposit has been seen in the banks in the fortnight, right? Then in the non-food credit growth, there has been a growth of 5.9% in, this was for non-food credit. Non-food credit growth. Then the loans of the into the industries, they have decreased by 1.2%. Decrease in loans. So number of loans given has decreased by 1.2%, and personal loans have decreased by 9.5%. 9.5% decrease in personal loans. Right? All right. Then we have a few one-liners. United Nations Capital Development Fund has appointed Preeti Sinha as Executive Secretary recently. And if we talk about UNCDF, it was established in 1966. The United Nations Capital Development Fund was established in 1966 and established by UNGA. And the purpose was to promote economic development in the country. Fourth thing, headquarters. Headquarters are in New York. Headquarters of UNCDF are in New York, right? And alright, that being it about it. Next we have is S. Theodore Bhaskaran. He is a writer, a historian, a naturalist, and even an activist, and he has won the Sanctuary Lifetime Service Award 2020 recently. And who has created this award? So this award has been created by Sanctuary Nature Foundation. Sanctuary Nation Foundation is the one which has created this award. And this award has been given for his dedication to wildlife conservation and for his writing prowess in English and even in Tamil, which is his regional language. So certain books that you need to know about, he has written certain books like Dance of the Saras, Essays of a Wandering Naturalist, and Book on Indian Dogs, and a David Sashma, Essays on Nature, David Sharma, Essays on Nature. So these are a few English books that have been written. Apart from that, there are certain Tamil books that he has written because it was his, you can say his regional language, right? Now, for his Tamilian work, he was given award by Canada Literary Garden. Canada Literary Garden had awarded him for his Tamil literature or his Tamil work, and this award was given in 2014 in Toronto. Then Nigerian economist Ngoi Okonu-Iweala has been appointed as the head of World Trade Organization, and becoming the head of World Trade Organization, she has become the first female to take this position, first African to take this position. Right, and if we talk about World Trade Organization, it has approximately 164 members. So don't forget the number of members of international organizations, especially those who are coming to news recently. Right, all right. Then going to the next one. Foundation Stone for Maharaja Suhail Dev Memorial is going to be set up in UP now. So, for COVID warriors, we had seen yesterday that it was in Odisha. And for this one, that is for Suhail Dev, we have Suhail Dev Memorial in UP, along with certain, developmental works that are going to be promoted. And that is for Chittora Lake in Bahrek. Chittora Lake. And both of them are going to be inaugurated by the Prime Minister of India. The Union Telecom Ministry has decided to set up Intelligence Unit and Consumer Protection System, and both of them will be helping tackle the threats which are associated with the pesky calls that are received. So to tackle all of those fraud calls, Telecom Ministry has decided to set up Intelligence Unit and Consumer Protection System. Right. So for all those telemarketers and individuals who call for harassment purposes, for them stricter regulations are going to be there, and without any fraudulent incident, if that is there, then certain regulations will be applying. But if there is something fraudulent that has taken place, some harassment that is taking place, for them there are certain strict actions are going to be created now, right? Then first route and terminal building of Kochi Water Metro has been inaugurated recently, and this is going to connect the islands, various islands across the city. So major metro route range from Vithla to Kakkad. And now here we have these two names which I said. One is Vithila and one is Kakkad. Now if we talk about these, Kakkanad. So if we talk about Vithila is a, if we talk about what it's famous for, it is the busiest traffic hub of Kerala, whereas Kakkanad, if we talk about, that is an IT hub of Kerala, right? Then we have India, which has liberalized its regulations on geospatial data, which is starting from 15th 2021. Now from 15th February, when these liberalization regulations have been regulated, what is the new thing that has come up? That is, now private companies can conduct the surveys and mapping with without getting an approval from government in advance. That is, an advance approval is not required any longer for conducting any sort of survey or mapping by any private organization. Right? Now, with this, we'll be winding up the segment. Thank you so much. It has been wonderful interacting with all of you, and I hope this session has been helpful to all of you. We'll see you in the upcoming sessions. Do like the video, share the video, subscribe to the channel, and also download Entry app for further updates. Thank you so much and have a wonderful day.